Good morning. I am Rabina. Today is Monday, October 12, 2020. Pakistan hopeful of acquiring COVID-19 vaccine within next 6 months. Islamabad. A Pakistani official from the Ministry of National Health Services has expressed hope that the country would acquire a vaccine against the novel coronavirus in the next 6 months. The official said on Sunday that Pakistan has also prepared antibodies against spike proteins, Dawn News reported. At present, 15 vaccines were in phase 3 trial globally, out of which 11 target the spike protein, he said. The official said the vaccine might not be effective for life and an energy booster would be required every year. Taking to Twitter on Sunday, Minister for Planning, Development and Special Initiatives Asad Amar said that positive cases in Pakistan that had remained below 2% for the last 6 weeks had now surpassed it. Speaking to Dawn News, Amar said that the nationwide maximum positive rate at the peak of the pandemic was recorded at 23%, while the minimum was 1.7%. Within 3 weeks, the positive rate went from 6% to 23%, therefore people need to understand that the virus can spread rapidly. We had observed that it was transmitting from restaurants and wedding halls, which was why we decided to revise the guidelines, he added. Currently, Pakistan's overall COVID-19 caseload has increased to 319,317, while the death toll stood at 6,580. Pakistan's coronavirus positive rate slightly increases. Pakistani health experts have said that there was a slight increase in the coronavirus positivity rate across the country, though the overall situation has continued to remain stable. The update was shared during a meeting on Thursday of the National Command and Operations Center, NCOC, presided over by its head and planning minister Asad Amar, the Express Tribune. According to latest update by the NCOC, 583 coronavirus cases were reported on Thursday, which increased the country's total tally to 317,424. The country's death toll currently stands at 6,550. The health experts also apprised the meeting about the pattern and prevalence of possible second wave in the world and particularly in the South Asian region. It was highlighted that a decline has been witnessed in following health guidelines, including wearing masks, social distancing, and no mask, no service protocols. It was mentioned that social events and large public gatherings, particularly restaurants and marriage halls, were identified as higher risk activities where guidelines were not being followed as directed by health experts. Speaking on the occasion, Amar emphasized that public safety was of utmost importance and successive national anti-COVID efforts should not be allowed to go waste. Thanks for watching Newstime 9.